फर्स्ट वन इज फॉरवर्ड कॉन्ट्रैक्ट, देन फ्यूचर कॉन्ट्रैक्ट एंड ऑप्शन कॉन्ट्रैक्ट, एंड वन मोर कॉन्ट्रैक्ट इज देयर दैट इज नॉट इन आवर सिलेबस, दैट इज स्वैप कॉन्ट्रैक्ट. सी नॉर्मली स्वैप कॉन्ट्रैक्ट इज इन इंटरनेशनल, व्हेन देयर इज अ इंटरनेशनल बिजनेस अ स्वैप कॉन्ट्रैक्ट विल बी टेकन प्लेस. बट एज पर सिलेबस वी हैव ओनली थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ फाइनेंशियल डेरिवेटिव्स, दैट इज फॉरवर्ड, फ्यूचर एंड ऑप्शन कॉन्ट्रैक्ट. सो विल सी what exactly forward contract and future contract and option contract in detail. Next one. Okay. The first one, first type of contract is a forward contract. The forward contract is nothing but it is an agreement between two parties to buy or sell an asset at a certain future time for a certain future price. So what exactly forward contract? Forward contract is a contract between two parties. So there will be two parties. Here one party is decided to buy underlying asset at an predetermined price, that is a future price for a future date. So that is called forward contract. And if you look at the features of forward contract, the first one is it is a bilateral contract because it takes place between two parties. It takes place between two parties. Consider there are two parties X and Y. So Mr. X, if Mr. X decided to buy, consider there are two parties X and Y. If Mr. X is the buyer and Mr. Y is the seller, consider Mr. Y is the seller. And here the contract between takes place between X and Y, and Mr. X decided to buy one product. Consider one product, that is gold. So Mr. X decided to purchase gold from Mr. Y at a predetermined price. That price will be decided at the time of entering into contract. Consider these two parties entered into contract today, that is 10th June 2021. Two parties entered into contract 10th June 2021, and the nature of contract, that is they have to exchange gold for money when they have to exchange in a future time, and at what price. That price should be decided at the time of entering into contract. So that is called forward contract. And here you can see the features of forward contract, that is a bilateral contract, bilateral, two parties X and Y, and these contracts are customized. Customized means normally forward contract take place over the counter market. It is not taken place in the stock market. Forward contract take place over the counter. Even in day-to-day life, in our day-to-day life, we normally engage in forward contract. We make a contract with our personal, or we make contract with our friends. That is after 1 month, give some items and I will give some price. So that is not basically called as a forward contract. And at that time, here there is no standardized rules. There is no standardized rules for forward contract. So you can make your own tailor-made contract. Tailor-made contract means, so you can decide the quantity, you can decide the price of the product. So you can decide the deal as well as the place of exchange for the contract. So that's why it is called customized. So both parties, that is buyer and seller, they can decide whatever the quantity and whatever the price and even place and quality of the product also. So that's why the forward contract is called customized. And third feature, there is a counterparty risk. Counterparty risk means, see, for example, here Mr. X made contract with Mr. Y to buy gold on after 1 month for a certain price. But on the date of maturity, that means after 1 month, Mr. Y or Mr. X, anyone, they can breach the contract because there is no regulation. They are not doing contract under any regulation or any board. So they can. So there is a possibility that one party may breach the contract. And if other parties cannot sue or he cannot get justified in the court because it is not under any regulation. So that's why it is called there is a counterparty risk. A counterparty risk means one party may breach the contract. Breach the contract or break the contract. So there is a chance of counterparty risk in forward contract. So these all this meaning and feature we'll understand once again when we discuss in the second unit in detail. Now just understand what do you mean by forward contract with a simple example. And here forward contract are normally not exchange traded. As I said, this will not be taken place with the help of stock market. So this is over the counter market, not exchange traded. Forward contract is not exchange traded. And the next one, the party that agrees to buy the asset in the future is long position. So whoever buy the forward contract or who takes buying position. So in forward contract, we call it as a long position. Who purchased the contract, who decided to purchase the contract, and his position, we call it as a long position. And the person who decided to sell the product or who decided to sell the contract is called short position. So basically there are two parties, the person who have long position and person who have short position. And the next one, the specified future date for the exchange is known as the delivery or maturity date. As I said, for example, they entered into contract on today, that is 10-6-2021. Consider that is the date of enter into contract, and they the duration of the contract is 1 month. So that means 10-7-2021 is the maturity date. So if the contract is for one month and the date of entering into contract is 10-6-2021, then the maturity date will be 10-7-2021. So that is called maturity period. Yes. Next one, see the one example for forward contract. By this example, you'll understand what exactly forward contract. See, the date of enter into contract, that is 11th August 2012. Mr. Tushar wants to buy 20 grams of gold, but his wife says he should buy gold only on the occasion of Diwali. So on 11th August 2012, Mr. Tushar wants to buy 20 grams of gold, but his wife says he should buy on the occasion of Diwali, like Akshaya Tritiya. So that is after 1 month, that is on 11th November 2012. So that is what occasion of Diwali. So what he can do, Mr. Tushar, he can enter into forward contract with jeweler, and he is worried about, see the example. Yeah. So this is the date of contracts, 11th August 2000. He decided to purchase the gold, but in the market, market is not going to purchase the gold from the market on 11th August 2012. Why? Because his wife said it is good to purchase gold on the occasion of Diwali. But Mr. Tushar don't know what may be the price on the date of 11th November 12. So it may increase or it may decrease on 11th November 2012. So if it is increased, he may face loss or he may incur loss. If it decreases, he can earn profit. So he is worried about the price fluctuation. But he wants to purchase it on the occasion of Diwali. So he is worried about price fluctuation. So what he do? He jeweler thinks price of gold are very high currently and may go up to this Diwali. So both parties, that is Tushar and jeweler, both are worried about the price fluctuation of gold. And here, Mr. Tushar has a different perspective than jeweler. So that means he thinks that the price of gold may, Mr. Tushar, he thinks that price of gold after 1 month may increase. And jeweler, he thinks that the price of the gold after 1 month may decrease. So what they do, they made contracts that is after 1 month, Mr. Tushar will buy 20 grams of gold, 20 grams of gold at a decided price. So that is the decided price. So now the current market of gold is 29,000. The current market price of the gold is 29,000. Yeah. See, transaction. Mr. Tushar and jeweler enters into contract on 11th August 2012. And here, as per the contract, Mr. Tushar will buy 20 grams of gold and the jeweler will sell 20 grams of gold on the maturity date. That is on 11th. The maturity date is 11th November 2012. The date of entering into contract is 11th August 2012. And Mr. Tushar will pay rupees 30,000 on the date of execution of the contract, that is the 11th November 2012, and he will receive the amount. So this is a forward contract. Trade happens today, settlement in future, and here both the parties get obligation, that is jeweler has to give gold to Mr. Tushar on the date of execution, and Mr. Tushar has to give 30,000 of amount on the date of execution of the contract, that is 11th November 2012. 12. See the contracts. Here the underlying asset is gold. Underlying asset is a gold. And the contract date is date of enter into contract is August 11, 2012. So they decided the contract price, predetermined price is 30,000 per 10 grams. So here Mr. Tushar decided to purchase 10 grams of gold at rupees 30,000 after 3 months, that is on November 11, 2012, irrespective of market price of gold at that time. So whatever may be the price on November 11, 2012, Mr. Tushar has to buy 10 grams of gold at rupees 30,000. And see, by entering into contract on August 11, 2012, what have the two parties done? So locked in future price of 30,000 per 10 gram. So on the settlement day, they have two way of settlement. One is they can physical delivery of product, or they can just exchange the difference between the predetermined price and the market price at the time of execution of the contract. Then around the settlement on the November, that is on November 11, 2012, what they have to, as per the contract, Mr. Tushar has to buy 20 grams of gold from jeweler at rupees 30,000 per 10 grams. So jeweler receives rupees 60,000 amount, and the contract ended, entered August to is settled, price of golding. Gold quoting in the spot market 28,000 per 10 gram. And See, what is the profit or loss from the contract? Consider the market price. Now the price of the gold coating in the spot market is 28,000. So on the date, that is on November 11, 2012, the market price of the gold is 28,000. But they decided to exchange the gold at 30,000. As per the contract price is 30,000, but the market price is 28,000. See, here Mr. Tushar has to buy 10 grams of gold is at 30,000. But in the market, it is available only for 28,000. So therefore, we can decide Mr. Tushar made loss from the forward contract. How? Because he paid 30,000. He paid 30,000 to jeweler for 10 grams of gold. But in the market, it is available for 28,000. And here both the parties has obligation. That means Mr. Tushar has to pay 30,000, whatever may be the market price. So in this example, Mr. Tushar made loss of rupees 2,000 per 10 grams. So he made 2,000 per 10 grams because he purchased at 30,000. And likewise, for jeweler made profit of 2,000 per 10 grams. And losser has to pay gainer the profit or loss. So that is the one way for exchanging. Mr. Tushar has to buy 20 grams of gold by paying 60,000 and jeweler receives 60,000 amount of cash and he has to pay 20 grams of gold. Or else they can settle only the profit or loss, the difference amount. The difference amount is 28,000 is the spot market or market price and 30,000 is the strike price or decided price. So the difference is 2,000 per 10 grams. Just pay 4,000, that is for 20 grams is 4,000. So Mr. Tushar has to pay 4,000 to jeweler. So as per the contract, Mr. Tushar has to pay excess amount, that is a profit, to jeweler. So that is the way of execution of the contract in forward contract. So how to find out the payoff? Payoff is nothing but profit or loss. How to find out profit or loss in forward contract? So this is the formula to find out profit or loss in forward contract. Estimate the spot price and K means a strike price. Strike price is nothing but predetermined price. The price at which they decided to execute the contract. See, in the previous example, the payoff, the profit or loss for the buyer. Previous example, buyer is the Tushar, Mr. Tushar. So what is the profit or loss? ST means a spot price. A spot price is 28,000. Sorry, spot price is 28,000 minus. And SK means a strike price, that is 30,000. So 28,000 minus 30,000 is the 2,000 is the loss for buyer, that is Mr. Tushar. And payoff for seller, that is strike price minus spot price or current market price. Strike price is 30,000. So 30,000 minus 28,000. So 2,000 is a profit for the seller. And time to expiration ST on the date of execution of the contract, what is the market price? Okay. Next. So this is the payoff diagram for buyer and seller. What is the payoff position for buyer? For buyer means long position. So this is the this point is determined price. strike price. So if current market price of that contract increases from the strike price, then he will make profit. Buyer will make profit if it is increases. So if it is decreased, if it is decreased from the strike price, then Mr. or buyer will make loss. So this is the long payoff diagram for buyer. Likewise for seller, if the current market price of the product decreases or below strike price, then he'll make profit. If the strike price of the product or the current market price of the product increases from the strike price, then he'll make loss. So that is the payoff profile of both buyer and seller. So in the next class, we'll discuss about future contracts. Now, if you have any doubt regarding forward contract, you can ask. I'll wind up here. Is any doubt about forward contract?
Hello, sir.
Okay, thank you.